XFM News. On point. Let's take a look at the news. The microfinance minister, Honorable Haruna Castle, has called on politicians to put politics aside as far as managing financial development associations, commonly known as MYOGA. The ministry last year started the MYOGA campaign that was introduced by the president to help Ugandans in organized groups formed according to their professions to aid them financially. Castle said there are some politicians who've resorted to swindling this money, warning that those caught will be dealt with lawfully. He said the government has over 260 billion to fund all circles across the country.
We have brought on board all the key stakeholders, and this is non-partisan. We are working together with all politicians from different political shades. So this is not money for eating, but we must encourage our people, we must train them, we must also empower them to manage this own fund, because it is for their own benefit. So they should make sure that the fund grows.
The acting executive director, Micro's Finance Support Center, Masika Petrolina Helen, said they're encouraging the MYOGA to save for their sustainability, not to just squander the money.
The money that we're disbursing out, it is not just money for eating. It is a revolving fund, and it is supposed to revolve within the MYOGA circles and the associations. From government, we are giving it to the circles. We don't expect it to come back to the Microfinance Support Center, but we expect this money to revolve within the MYOGA circles and the associations. This is seed capital. It is a gesture. The president wants to start with this whole thing. He's like, okay, we're encouraging people to save. Let me do the saving first, and then the rest follow.
NRM Youth League leaders have expressed their dissatisfaction over the criteria used to pick people campaigning for the party flag bearer without the inclusion of youth. The youth interim chairperson, Charles Twaib, said the highest percentage of voters are youth, and therefore they need to be engaged in this exercise of harnessing votes for President Museveni. Asha has called upon the party chairman, Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, to meet them as youth leaders and give them a chance to steer the wheel for his campaigns instead of fronting musicians and old members.
But to our dismay, in your campaign, you can't hardly see the engagement of youth for mobilization. Now, the young people are being confused by Bobuan's camp, and your youth are quiet because they are not seeing the engagement at any level, from national to the grassroots level. However, the old guards have continued to seal you off from the young people, and access for young people to you has become a nightmare.
United Nations Development Programme wants government to prioritise investing in climate change to curb its negative effects on the economy. The project manager, UNDP, Gloria Namande, says increasing growth of industries without measures to curb air pollution, environmental degradation, among others, poses a great threat.
It has brought stress on the economies. We've seen that the budget allocations have become very limited for even the national level activities. And climate change sometimes has been secondary. We've seen even with the first climate change plan that we had for the government, for the first NDC from in 2015. And now with the COVID-19 situation, it's going to be more difficult. But what we need to do, we need to ensure that the recovery plan has to consider of a green recovery plan. You know, we are developing countries usually rely on grants. But because of the current COVID-19 situation, the economic crisis, so many donors are reducing their support to the budget. So what other innovative ways are we talking about? We have to look at the private sector.
In other news, authorities in South Africa's Western Cape province have expressed deep concern over a sharp jump in COVID-19 cases. The virus is showing signs of a resurgence in parts of South Africa, the most badly affected country on the continent. After a long lull, infection rates have beginning to rise in some areas, particularly along the country's southern coastline. Doctors in Cape Town and in Port Elizabeth are reporting a spike in hospital admissions. One provincial leader described the increase as staggering and said the virus is spreading widely and protection is low and nationwide protest against overlaw pay of community health workers, key figures in South Africa's fight to contain the virus. The country is now heading towards the main summer holiday season, a time when millions of people travel. With the economy in deep trouble, the government is thought to be reluctant to reimpose tough lockdown restrictions. And that was the news.
XFM News on point.